So in January 2021, I bought this cork bark black pine. This right here is my brand new cork bark Japanese black pine. It's been picked up recently. I love this tree. It is very, very healthy, very dense, amazing bark. And I can't wait to kind of get my hands on it and kind of play around with it and, you know, develop this into a more refined tree. Let's take a closer look at it. This Nabari right here, depends on what side you look at it, is about 7 inches across. And it has these deep, barky trunk, and lots of great, beautiful branches. If you look at this tree closely, you can see that there's a difference in terms of the bark. This is a cork bark. Not quite sure what variety yet. Cork barks tend to have this deep fissure. So yeah, I'm gonna play around with this tree this coming spring and start to work on refining it, probably change the planting angle a little bit. As of right now, the front is, maybe this was the intended front. And the pot is definitely not the correct pot for this tree. So you know, I need to find something probably just as deep, but wider, or even taller actually, because of this kind of semi-cascade branch right here that would literally touch the table if I had too shallow of a pot. So yeah, probably will do some needle plucking on this tree to kind of balance it out. It's pretty balanced as it is. And then repot this coming spring. Okay, so I've been going through and I've been thinning out the tree and cutting the needles instead of plucking them, because this way, if I leave the fascicles, and I'll show you what the fascicles look like, it's basically what the needles are attached to. If I leave these fascicles, I leave more opportunity for back budding. So I'm cutting instead of plucking, because if you pluck out those fascicles, you won't have any, well, there's a very small chance that you will have back budding further down the branch. It's not impossible, but it makes it definitely a lot more difficult. So this is what the tree looks like so far. I've done about, I don't know, 40% of the tree, and I'm cutting it back because I'm starting from the top. I'm cutting it back because I want more light penetration, and I'm basically, you know, instead of plucking, I'm cutting. So I've done this side somewhat, still this half kind of to go. And I'm really trying to create balance. There's some areas where there's a lot more vigor than others. And I could tell that the inner branches were getting shaded out. And so that's why I'm going in. It's kind of doing this work now. You kind of needle pluck any time of the year. But all I'm doing is I'm cutting it back, opening up that canopy so that more light can penetrate during the winter time. And then I'll do some more work on this tree, thinking about the design and repot in the spring. Okay, so I've got most of this tree thinned out. I'm going to just kind of look around the tree and make sure I haven't missed any of the branches. Otherwise, I've got fertilizer pots at the bottom. This tree is good to go for the winter. right, in this video, we're gonna take this big Japanese cork bark black pine and repot it. So I got this Japanese black pine from John Muth, the owner of Bonsai Northwest. I picked it up when I bought a few other things from him. You can see here the deep fissures on that trunk. Look at that, just beautiful. Very well ramified tree, very old. My guess would be 50 plus years, but it's a beautiful tree. It's in a not so beautiful pot. It really does not display the tree in a way that I want to display it. So today we're gonna repot it into a nice Tokoname pot from Japan, and then give it, I guess, a little bit more breathing room. Pool, it's ready to go. We're gonna use it as a the catch for all the soil, and let's take this thing down off the bench. Okay, it's pretty heavy as it is. All right, so we've got the black pine in the pool. It's not going swimming or anything. I'm pulling off some of these net pots that have the fertilizer in them, so we can work on this tree. You know, I'm examining the soil. It's just gravel. It's not Akadama, it's not lava rock, it's not pumice, it's not Optizorb, it's not turfus, it's just gravel. So it's not in the best soil. This is not the ideal soil for this type of tree. So it definitely needs a repotting. We're almost a little bit late in the season because the candles are starting to push a little bit, but I'm not gonna do root work unless it, you know, there's some major ones. I do want to get a better look at it and just try slip potting it into the new pot. Ready to come out. And the trick about pulling this thing out and handling a cork pine such as this is not messing up that bark. That bark takes decades to develop, and I don't want to do anything that will cause harm to it or peel it off or flake it off. You know, it might happen, but I found this little gin piece here that I could probably grab a hold of and try to pull it out from there, because this bark is so delicate, just so delicate. The last thing I want to do is damage it. I'm gonna need you to hold the pot.
Okay,
I'm gonna lift and then you're gonna pull the pot out. All I'm doing now is just kind of keeping the roots nice and wet and moist. It is a warmer day than usual, and we're gonna need to tease out some of these roots so that way they can move into the additional soil that we're gonna pack into it. Looks like there is some Akadama as we get a little bit deeper, and the gravel on top was more for decorative, but it is dense. It is very, very dense. So I'm just gonna perforate it. Give it a little shake. Give it a little shake. And go all the way around. That's good. Okay, so I pulled off all the dead roots kind of on the outer edge here, and I'm just kind of teasing it versus bare rooting this thing. letting some of these new strands, you know, come out, feed into the new soil that we're going to put into the new pot. And then that way it isn't root bound and doesn't continue to grow in a circle because of that that round pot that it was in. Like I said, we're going to slip pot today. It's root bound, but it's not terrible. And you know, after this repot, we'll probably could let it go another 3 to 4 years before doing another one, because it's going to go in a lot more soil, give it that room it needs to spread its roots. See these roots here? They're going around in circles, and I want to just loosen them up so that way they can spread. It'll also improve the nabari when there's better root spread. You know, circling roots is never a good thing. Okay, look at this. This was all found from a couple of the roots at the bottom of the pot. Some of them was trying to escape from the mesh holes. And we're just gonna cut these off because they have no place in here. And this is just kind of a little bit of a cleanup, but my gosh, this is a good half pound of roots that were either dying or circling the bottom of the pot. I think that's about enough. I don't want to do too much today. Here's the pot. I'm going to change the planting angle of this pine. The way it was in the previous pot, I didn't love the angle of that tree. So we're going to do a little bit of a tilt when we get in here. I'm going to use some large pumice to build up my cone at the bottom. Got a little Akadama mix into here. These are large granules as well. This is the front. Yeah. Oh yeah. That planting angle looks so much better. Bring it towards you just a little bit more, Brian.
Uh-huh.
Just a little bit more.
More?
A little bit more. Okay. I like it. I'm gonna shift this down just a little bit. That way we're off center. Okay? Yes. I think I like that a lot. Alright, take a look at this. See the tree? That's kind of the angle that I wanted at. But I like it a lot better than how it was. I might shift it or rotate it by a couple degrees, but it looks so much better this way. Okay, I think we found our planting angle. And I'm just gonna fill in the soil to keep this angle. Either that or I'll just keep Brian at my house standing next to the tree for the next few years. Hold your breath a little bit. And then do me a favor, grab a couple of the cut bamboo pieces from that little table. We're gonna chopstick it in.
Okay.
Got your hand?
Yep.
Go. You lead? Okay, so here's the tree, brand new planting angle. I really dig this angle. It really shows off the power of the tree. And this pot with this ridge right here kind of mimics these deep ravines in the cork. So it's a fantastic pot to correlate well with this type of tree. We're just gonna water it, add the moss, and it's good to go for the next few years. Just taste. All I love is love it. Yeah. Third week of June, we're going to hit some really warm temperatures here. Record-breaking temperatures in June for Seattle. And, well, trying to hide all my deciduous material behind a little bit of shade, and I'm watering like five times a day. But what you're looking at here is the corkbark Japanese black pine. It is time to decandle this puppy. And it's probably going to happen through several phases. I don't have enough time to just kind of sit through and do this all in one go. Once I do that, I'll probably do a little bit more needle reduction and then try to wire this thing in a way that shows off the trunk of this baby. Look at that. Yeah, showcase that a little bit more. So let's go ahead and do that. Okay, so the tree has officially been decandled, and I did cut off some branches that I felt were going outside of the silhouette that I like, and I'm just kind of doing a quick walk around to see if I've missed any candles, and it looks like I did right here. Let's take a look at this one. Kind of easy to miss when there are so many branches and candles on the tree. There's one right there. If I don't cut that, that one candle could potentially get really long because everything else has been cut off, and all the energy will be redirected into that leftover candle. I did leave some of the really weak candles kind of on the inside that I want to develop. There's no, you know, well, I didn't want to cut those because I want those to get stronger and get caught up to the rest of the tree. But this should do it. I'm not going to needle pluck right now. I'm actually going to see if I can leave some of the needles in places where I want back bud. And my needle pluck, most likely, you know, I'll kind of take away any opportunity for back budding. So that is about it. It's a nice, healthy tree. So in this part of the video, which was in the October timeframe of 2021, this was kind of the last few videos that I made, actually, around that time frame. I had a couple siblings who really fell ill with cancer around this time frame, so I stopped making videos. I kind of refocus my energy on my family, and I really didn't get a chance to work on this tree as much as I would like. But, you know, priorities are priorities. So, unfortunately, I did have a couple siblings die in the process of making this video. One died in January and the other died in February. And they both left behind 5 kids each. And so all of my energy was really directed towards them, towards my family at that time frame. So it wasn't until the beginning of March where I got kind of back into the groove of doing things and, you know, started kind of living my life again. And so, you know, the tree didn't get worked on as much as I would hope to around that time frame. But it's not an excuse. I would have liked to wire the tree a lot more than the way I had it. And then just to kind of keep it clean and some of the branches in place and keep the pads a lot cleaner. But, you know, that was kind of the main reason why the tree didn't look like it was 100% in show form. All right, so my big black pine here, corkbark black pine, is going into the spring show. And I just freshened up the moss. I want to get it kind of established. It's dried out some. So I've been watering it daily to kind of green it up a little bit more. And then I need to go throughout the tree, clean up some of the dead needles, kind of get it a little bit more show ready. I haven't wired it as much as I wanted to, but the tree for the most part already kind of has its shape. You know, there's a couple parts kind of outside of the silhouette, but it's okay. You can see down here I've collected some new moss. to apply to the bottom of the pot or the top of the pot. And looks pretty good. Kind of green. I wish it was kind of brown. I wish it was a lot more green than that. But hopefully, as I water it, it'll perk up a little bit by Friday. So yeah, there you go. Then we'll see what it looks like in the show. Well, naturally, it's a rainy day, and it's the day before our club spring show. And I have to drive this tree down to the Pacific Bonsai Museum down in Federal Way so that it can be ready for the show on Saturday and Sunday for the Bonsai Fest this weekend. This one I did for the Kusumono. Use some Mondo grass in this really crackled pot, just kind of to represent in miniature the corking and crackling of the bark on this tree, and grass kind of represents the needles. So that's the look I'm going for. I need to get this thing loaded into the car, and that's not going to be an easy task for this giant pot, this heavy tree, and about 100 pounds of soil. So and pot combined. Yeah, not gonna be fun. This is a two-man tree easily, and I'm not as strong as I used to be. So yeah, we'll see. Let's go from here. Oh, this thing weighs a ton. Of course it's raining and slippery, because I just applied oil to the pot, so gotta be really careful. At least I got it on the truck. All right, we have made it to the museum. Tree looks all right. Let's unload.
Good morning. My name is Lad Smith. I am the PSBA president for 2022 and 23, and we're here at our spring show for this season, just opening up our club again after post-pandemic, doing in-person functions, and also doing our events like the spring show here with Bonsai Fest at the Bonsai Museum. Okay, we are here today at the PSBA Spring Show for 2022. Behind me are some of the outstanding plants that we have from our members that have donated their trees for this show and stuff, including this beautiful black pine from Dan Robinson from the Landon Gardens. Look at the stature of this one and the short needles. Absolutely beautiful trees. Come on down and check them out. Look at this phenomenal specimen. Coral bark, Japanese black pine, estimated about 75 years old. Really getting into some nice refinement right now and getting the shorter needles. Give it a couple more years, this will be a phenomenal plant.
So as the show came to a close, I realized a couple things. I wanted the needles on my black pine to be a lot shorter after seeing how Dan Robinson got his to be pretty short. Actually, very short. So that's one of the goals I want to achieve with this pine in the next few years. And then the other thing is, a Kusamono game was definitely weak. So I went out and I bought some additional accent plants that I can have to pick and choose from, depending on what kind of tree I want to display in the future. So thanks for following me on this journey with this cork bark black pine as it made its way into the Bonsai Show for our club. I appreciate it. You made it this far. That means that you are one loyal person. And I appreciate that. Don't forget to like and subscribe. See you on the next video. I have a lot more to come.